Does Max's problem seem familiar to you? Have you ever faced yourself an HMI panel, login, or password of which you don't know? If yes, you've come to the right place. Here we talk about little things which make your life as a user of ABB automation products easier. My name is Yuri. I'm a member of a training team of PLC Center of Expertise here in Heidelberg. Let's run the intro. So first, there is no magic trick or master password of some sort which would unlock your CP600 panel. You would need to reset it to factory state. Good news, login and password will be gone. Bad news, you will lose your project as well. I will repeat it again. Next steps will lead to clearing all the data from your panel, including all existing projects. If you're okay with that, let's jump to the device itself.
Okay, what I'm about to show you will work on all modern CP600 panels with BSP, or Boot Support Package, version 1.3 and later, which are CP600 Eco, CP600 Second Generation, and CP600 Pro.
So, first we need to have a panel switched off, then power it on again, and then follow so-called tap-tap procedure, which, as the name suggests, require a number of taps anywhere on a screen of panel. Once panel detects that we want to get into tap-tap menu, which is actually displayed in this blue ribbon, we need to select menu item. In first menu is a system settings, so we just leave it as it is, and a countdown will get us to next screen. And here, in order to go to device restore, we need to tap on a screen and hold the finger until panel will get into restore mode. And now panel will start resetting itself to default settings. Now we have erased old password information from the panel, but it is still not usable because according to security requirements, we need to set up new user and admin passwords. And in order to connect to panel, we need to have IP address set. So let's do just that. We go to system settings, and then panel will greet us with a prompt to enter new user and later admin password with some password requirements. Like there should be at least 8 characters in total. There should be at least one lower and one uppercase letter. There should be one numerical and one special character. So you need to come up with password which fulfills those requirements. In my case, I'll be very creative and use CP600-Pro. So, panel accepts our user password, and now we do the same for admin. User and admin passwords could be different. Now panel will reboot and we have our passwords set. Now it's turn off IP address. We still go to system settings. Only difference this time we need to enter admin and password we set before. And now we jump into system settings. In order to set up IP address, we need to go to network menu, press edit, go to network interfaces, and disable DHCP, and then set desired IP address. In my case, it's 192.168.0.10. And don't forget network mask, which corresponds to your IP address. In case if you have a gateway, you can set up it as well, but in my case, that's not necessary. You close, you save, and after a while, panel will take those settings in. And that's how you reset a panel to factory state. Please, don't lose your passwords. Keep automating, and have a lovely day.